speak on their behalf. The reason why you have to pray for them is because someone stood on their behalf and spoke curses in their lives. Amen. So I want you to stand in the gap for your family. I want you to pray for yourself. Amen. That whatever has been running in your bloodline, in your generation, can be broken in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of stagnation, everything that has been reigning in your family, you need to cancel it. Be it a problem of immorality, be it poverty, you need to stand on the gap for your family. You know that your family has cycles of stagnation, cycles of poverty. Your father died without even leaving anything. But you need to start a new generation. We are going to pray non-stop. You're not going to look at the person next to you. We are going to pray up until we start the next session. Don't wait for me to bring another prayer point. That's the prayer point.
And I say, Lord, you know, these dry bones,
nations. I have set you amongst countries. I have set you amongst kingdoms. We have been given power over the kingdom of darkness to stand in the prophetic. I have given you power over the kingdom of darkness that has been in your family for a very long time. In the name of Jesus, that we are wearing the prophetic jacket. I am wearing the apostolic mantle. All in the name of Jesus, then I represent the kingdom of power, which is suffering violence. And by force, I bring the kingdom of God in my family. In the name of Jesus, I am Heavenly Father, you've given me power to speak and to tread over scorpions. In the name of Jesus, just like Jeremiah, I have been given the authority, I have been given the power to stand on the nations and kingdom, to break, to black out, to destroy, just like David, when the Ammonites took his wife and his belt, he came to you, Lord, and said, God, should I pursue? And if I pursue, will I overtake? Heavenly Father, I speak on my behalf of my family. Whatever has been stolen by the enemy, that the enemy has taken in my family, I am going to pursue. Kataya, Kataya, Sakataya. Pursue. I am going to pursue my job. I am going to pursue my marriage. I am going to snatch it from the enemy's hands. I am going to overtake. And God, it shall be multiplied. Tenfold, sevenfold. Whatever the yes, the locusts are stolen, they are being restored. Every reign of the enemy that has happened in my family, I am breaking it in the name of Jesus. Pray and pursue. Pursue everything that the enemy has done in your life. Refresh it. Speak deliverance of your siblings, of your mother. Any sickness, Shalalabaya Sokatakadia, it is written in the volume of the scriptures, that by his stripes we are healed. Heavenly Father, I thank you in the mighty name of Jesus, by his stripes we are healed. Kayamlaha Sakatakadia, every sickness, I pray, oh God, every genetic malfunction in my family, I come against it in the name of Jesus. Right now, I stand as the Son of the Living God in the prophetic authority of our Father, Dr. Jerome Williams, and the anointing that has been put on him to deliver each and every person who is in this house from the weapon of darkness in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray, Almighty God, under the anointing of our director, in the name of Jesus, the spirit of worship, the spirit of truth, for truth is to worship, the spirit of noise, to stand at the walls of Jericho, and to speak it out, and to break the walls that have been erected by the enemy, in the name of Jesus. And I speak a shout. It is getting done. It is getting over. This is your season. Why not? Because God said yes. I see in the spirit that God is taking you. And whatever is planned, enemy is your power. Doors are opening that have never opened before. Come and pray. Heavenly Father, I stretch out my hands. I intercede. I pray right now for the church, for the ministry, for this place. There is no person who enters that door who will come back the same. I refuse, because it is not in your design that whenever a person gets in this place, they come back the same. Yes. oh God, that any person who's traveling in drugs, when they enter there in the atmosphere of liberty, they are free from everything. In the name of Jesus, may the anointing that bless witnesses prevail in the house right now. Jesus Christ, whatever the enemy has planned in your life, I am canceling and I'm nullifying. I am obliterating whatever witchcraft has been raised in your future marriage, in your future husband, in your job, in your business deal, in whatever you're touching. Whatever you've touched all these years, it is turning into gold. Even if things have not worked, but I can hold, put the promise of the Holy Ghost, the fire of the Holy Spirit, that it shall never be consumed. Right now you're being released. Release. 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 Break. Break, break each and every chain that has kept you in the very same place. Just like in the Bible, we shall not stay in this place for a very long time. We shall not wander in the wilderness, because we have been given the promise of the Holy Spirit. We have been on Kadesh Barnea for a very long time, but it is time to break camp and move forward. I do not care how long the situation is persistent. This is the time of the Lord. Jesus has to take his place. Demons have made your life a playground. But I speak deliverance right now. Demons have masqueraded you, have raped you, have done whatever they want. You have been an object. But never, you are a child of God. You are a royal priesthood. You are a son of God. You are an apostle. You are a prophet. You are standing in for your family because you have to stand first. You are getting delivered, whether they like it or not. You are standing, you are becoming different. You are peculiar. You are different. You are above. You are beyond. You are being set apart in the name of Jesus. God is raising you. The enemy is not the one in charge. The power of the Holy Spirit is in charge. Rakatana Maya Setatana Maya. Reketana Pasoka Tanahia. Rakatana Mabos. Come on. You have a few minutes to push. Push. Speak life. Speak deliverance. You're progressing. You're progressing. I don't care how long you've been in the situation. Pray. Because God is here. The deliverer is here. You have lost hope. You have lost life. You don't have anything new to move. But I say to you, blind man, start to see. You have not walked for 38 years. I do not care your age, whether you are married or not. God has nothing to do with your age. God will do it. If he did it to Sarah, he will do it to you. If he did it to Abraham, he will do it to you. If he did it to Samson, he will do it to you. If he did it to Esther, if he made Esther the queen, he is raising you as the queen. I don't care what people think, what people say. You have not moved for 38 years. But I say, even if you don't have legs, rise up and walk. Rise up. And walk, rise up, and walk, rise up, and walk, rise up, and walk. We are breaking in every chain in the name of Jesus. We are upsetting the plan of the enemy in the name of Jesus. They are recycling, they are regenerating in the name of Jesus. Come on. Shout!
everybody doing?
Are you okay?
Okay, I'm glad that you are, amen. So we welcome you all to Power of God Deliverance Ministries. We welcome you all with love, gladness, and happiness. So, in over, I have lived under the sun for over 2 decades, right? If you don't know what a decade is, gonna think it's 100 years, but okay, it's fine. So I have lived under the sun for over 2 decades, and the one thing that I've noticed is that there's nobody who has such a perfect golden life. There's nobody who has this happy ending life. Everybody has some obstacles, amen. Some up and down, sometimes you feel sick, sometimes you are all healthy, sometimes you are sad, sometimes you are happy, sometimes we are crying, sometimes life is throwing all other things to us. And most of the time we carry this perfect picture, we portray to be superheroes, supermen, superwomen, that everything is going, is doing fine, especially these days in social media, we take ourselves smiling, but deep inside we know we're crying. So in case you have lost hope, you feel weak, physically, financially, mentally, here's what the Lord is saying to you. 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9 says, "But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses, so that Christ's power may rest on me." My grace is sufficient for you. In case you think that your last bar of grace is finished, he said that my grace for you is sufficient. In whatever situation, whatever circumstance, he said that his grace is sufficient. There's this word that I once heard saying that the more you sin, the more the grace you have. The more Jesus wants you closer, the more his grace is more to you. So let's just know that Jesus Christ is our strength, he's our refuge, he's our Father. As we start this year, as we have read, the prophecy is saying that this year is going to be a very difficult year for Christians. If you didn't know, let me tell you, it's going to be a difficult year for Christians. I wish I knew, but I can't tell you that. So we're going to feel weak, we're going to feel maybe defeated, but then he's saying that his grace is sufficient. He will never leave us, nor will he ever forsake us. Amen. So let's just remember that as we start this week, as we're going to start February, January disease is ending, thank God. And then as we start this new year, amen. Amen. Now it's time for praise. Praise in action. What's wrong with you? Not praise in worship, praise in action. We praise and then we act. Let's stand up and praise our Lord. Amen. Today, please, I don't want to see people looking at me. Hey, please, I beg you. I don't want to see you looking at me, not singing for your God. I know be your God. So please, I know be your God. Let's praise and worship our God with all our heart, all our soul, and all our mind. Amen. So I'm taking you to Congo. Hey, somebody loves Congo, but I'm not going to mention it. So let's say, I said, I don't be your God.
Thank you. song, many, really, really important. There are two songs that are very important for me to play them before we enter into time of the word. So I'm kind of asking all of us to be on our feet, amen. Okay, you can also join them, hallelujah.
Ah!
me to humble myself to the grace, the blessings Amen. Of this house. Allow me to humble myself to the father of this house, Dr. Jerome Williams, and his ascension. Allow me to humble myself before my brothers who are in this house. Allow me to humble myself before my sisters in this house. Allow me to humble myself before all the ministers, all the leaders of this house. God, I say take over in this house. Let not my will, but your will be done, O God. Let my voice, let my body be used as a vessel, O God, to deliver the good news in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place to take over. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be unto the living God. Amen.
Amen.
This is the day that the Lord has made. If you are not smiling up until now, my friend, you are a suspect. Ah, you are a suspect. This is a beautiful day that the Lord has made. Hallelujah. So we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. So standing in front of you is Minister Luna. she likes calling me Luna, but anyway, is it as well? It's Minister Luna. By God's grace, I am anointed minister and ordained by God using Dr. Jerome Williams. Amen. And by God's grace as well, I'm an anointed elder of the Power of God Deliverance Ministries. I just want to thank God for that. Amen. I've said something. Did you greet your neighbor? Go and shake them. Go and shake them. Go and shake them. Hallelujah. Go and shake them. Go and shake them. Go and shake them. And ask them, how are they doing? How are they doing? On this beautiful day, how are they doing? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, yes. Give them love. Give them love. As a chosen generation, give them love. Give them love. Lead by example. If you are the chosen generation, go and love your brother. Go and love your brother. Go and love your brother. Show them love. They need it. They need it. Because last night we were not together. They were in their houses. Amen. We are all coming from different places. Hallelujah. So you don't know what happened last night. You don't know even what happened yesterday since it was weekend. So at least if you give them that, just, you know, a shaking offering, they will feel better. Amen. Did we greet all our brothers and our sisters? Oh, Brother John is still greeting. Hallelujah. Oh, God is good. Amen. God is good. Amen. So the reason why I had to play this song first, I wanted it to minister before I say any word. We are the chosen generation. We are the chosen generation. I'm still surprised about some of our sisters and our brothers who feel discouraged by still coming in this house to fellowship with others. I am still surprised by our brothers and our sisters who are still shy to tell the world that, you know what, I'm a born-again Christian. Let me tell you something. You are the chosen generation. As long as you come in this house, praying with us, doing what everybody is doing in the name of the Lord, doing what is right, not what is wrong, but doing what is right, you are the chosen generation. Amen. Tell your neighbor that I am the chosen generation. I am holy. I am righteous. I am beautiful. I am whole enough to be called the chosen generation. I don't know about you, but as for myself, I am the chosen generation. I am the soul of the earth. Amen. Before I mislead you with my 2 cents English, let us open the Bible. Okay. Luke 2, verse 42. So, the theme of the day is exemplary youth. I once preached just a little in our morning glory prayer, but I didn't finish. Exemplary youth. preaching the word of God, what are we doing out there for us to be called the exemplary youth? Amen. So may we all open to the book of Luke 2, verse 42 to 52, Minister Masley. 2, verse 42 to 52. Hallelujah. Did we hear her correctly? Jesus lived an exemplary life. And as for me, he is my role model. What about you? Who is your role model? And as a person also who is following Christ, how many people are looking up to you? And how many of the things of God have you abandoned? Did you know that there are a lot of people when you walk out that door, they see that you come here for the morning glory prayer. They follow you. You are their role model. Did you know that? And when you are out there, now misleading people, what impact are you giving the people? So as I have said, Jesus lived an exemplary life. People looked to him because he was worthy of honor. We are the followers. We are the disciples of Christ, right? And we also have people who are following us. Are we doing the right thing? Are we leading these people as an example? Are we doing what we are supposed to be doing? Or we are doing a, what do they call it? We are doing this kona-kona things, right? We're doing kona-kona things. Amen. People looked unto Jesus because he was worthy of honor. He was praiseworthy of imitation. Today you are called the leader of the AACCT. You are called the minister of the Power of God Deliverance Ministries. You are called the leader of this house. You are also called the prayer warrior of this house. After you pray,
are learning from you. We might learn from you when you pray here, right? But when you also go out there, it matters. Your lifestyle, how you carry yourself, how you dress, it matters. Amen. Hallelujah. Now we have John 9, verse 1 to 7. John 9, verse 1. So there is something that I learned from John 9, is that, did you notice that all this Jesus was doing, it was in his youth? We are still in our youth. Why do we have to wait, you know, to be in a relationship in order for us to do the will of God? Why do we have to wait for us to be, you know, in Mary saying, I'm going to answer the call when I get married? Start now. Start now, Brother John. Start now. Wherever you go, start now with your Bible. Start preaching the word of God. Don't say, I'm waiting for Dr. Jerome to come back from the States. At least if he sees me on the pulpit, you know, I'll show him my skills. Let me tell you something. This is not for Dr. Jerome. This is for God. You need to answer your calling and do what you are supposed to be doing, because there are a lot of souls out there. Let me tell you something. There are so many souls out there who are waiting for Brother Blessing to go out there and win them. If you die today, you will be judged for it. Wake up and answer your call and do what you are supposed to be doing, because you never know, some of those blessings that we are praying for, that God, I need money. God, I need this and that. There is a call that you need to answer. Doing the word of God, the work of God, is not just by you standing here. No. I was talking to my brothers this other day, that even coming in this house, cleaning the chairs, without Minister Maski telling you that, you know, we need people who can come and clean for us. Because mind you, that you are not doing this for us, but you are doing for the Lord. So that after you clean, when the angels of the Sunday service, when they come to bless this house, when they find this house clean and tidy, they will know that Brother Stella was here. He cleaned. That wasn't just a cleaning, it was a service. He was made. Amen. So start now. Jesus started when he was 12. I am 28. You are 32, maybe you are 25, she is 23. So what's stopping you? What's stopping you? Amen, you're a child. What is stopping you? Do not be discouraged. Do not be dismayed. Don't be a bench warmer. When you come inside the church, you are waiting for somebody to clean the chair for you. You're waiting for somebody to intercede for you. You're waiting for somebody to preach. Start something. God will meet you halfway. Brother
latch on. Listen to the voice of God and do what you are supposed to be doing. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. As you have, seen, do you see people in the world? Those who smoke, those who drink, they are not ashamed. They are very proud. And if you go to the club, they are very proud of who they are. What about you? What about you? When it comes to services, you give an excuse. But those people who are serving their gods, when they are supposed to meet at 10, they meet exactly at 10 on a dot. But you, a child of God, you have people who are looking up to you. The church starts at 2, you come in at 3. How then are we going to learn from you? How then are we going to learn from you? Amen. Ask your neighbor and say, neighbor, are you really the chosen generation? If you are really the chosen generation, then answer the call. Tell them. Tell them. If you are really the chosen generation, answer the call. Answer the call. It is not easy, guys. Let me tell you something. It's not easy. I told you that I wasn't good in English. And when that was my only excuse, I told Dr. Jerome that you said this to your people. When I stood in front, they would laugh at me. He said, it's not about your English. It's about your heart. Because you're not praying to those people. But you're praying to God. God is the one who hears. And whoever that hears and condemns you with your broken English, then that's his problem. Do the work of God. You don't have shoes, it's okay. You don't have a beautiful dress for you to start the word of God. It's the work of God, it's okay. Tell God, leave that to God. They always give an example of saying God's bill is what? Exactly. If it's God's will, it is God's will. Do not think on behalf of him. Thank our God. Okay, you called me. What about this shoe? You never know how many people you are going to meet to Christ without your broken shoe, with barefoot. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I forgot to give the definition of what is living an exemplary life. It's living a life that sends a positive examples for others to follow. I want you to search your heart that I come at the AACCT each and every day. I come for the morning glory prayer. What kind of an example am I setting? Like, whose attention am I really trying to get? Search inside your heart that, okay, am I really living an exemplary life? Amen. So it's living a life that sets a positive example for others to follow. This includes living with integrity, being honest and ethical in all your dealings, treating others with respect, being kind and generous, and striving to make the world a better place. How many people have come to you crying that, Sister Luna, this and this is happening in my life? And after you counsel that person, you go to Sister Luna and say, did you know? Mama, then you came to me. She said, 1, 2, 3. You are doing it in the closet, right? Nobody is there, but let me tell you something. God is there because she trusted you with her life. And you with your big mouth, you are going to spread it. What kind of life are you living? What kind of a leader are you? What kind of an impact are you giving to the person that you are telling? And what does that say? Amen. So to those who didn't hear, it's living a life that sets a positive example. Let when Sister Lebo brings
Come on, somebody say hallelujah. The devil is a liar. Amen. Amen. If there is any spirit of pride that is using us, that spirit of pride has to leave us. Amen.
Amen.
We want to set an example. Amen. We want, you know, to give impact to the people. Amen. Hallelujah. There's this day when I was preaching our morning prayer saying that when we teach about love here, it doesn't have to end in this house. There are a lot of people who are waiting for you there. They know that Brother Stello has gone for the morning glory, and we are waiting for him. We are waiting for him to see what they were teaching him. And then comes Brother Stello. He has forgotten everything. He left everything in this house. If there is a fight, he's there to say, beat him, beat him, beat him. And at the end of the day, they'll be asking, you say you're going for the morning glory prayer, where? At the end center. Wow. Who is the founder? Who is the founder there? It's Dr. Jerome Williams. He's an American. Oh, he's an American. So this is what he's teaching you. And at the end of the day, people run away. They'll be like, we don't want to be Christians anymore. We don't want to be Christians anymore because of what we are doing to others. So if there is any spirit of pride in this house, any spirit of ego in this house, any spirit of condemning one another, any spirit of looking down upon one another, instead of us to learn from one another, it has to leave. It has to leave. Amen. It has to leave. Amen. I know that it has ears. Amen. Every time we gather, there will always be a monitoring spirit. Don't be that guy who is caught off guard. Instead of you to focus, you start to look at the person's shoe. You start to look at Brother Blessing's blue air suit. You're like, oh my God, look at that. Look at that. And then you poke another person. Look at that. And you start laughing. And now you have missed the blessing.
Amen.
And at the end of the day, you are stuck. Going to repeat Matthew 5 verse 13 to 16. You are the salt of the earth. Say to yourself, I am the salt of the earth.
I
am the salt of the earth.
Let
me remind you something. In December, I think on the 24th, I told people that if you don't speak a word of life to yourself, forget about anybody coming to you and say, blessing you are great. Bless you in the soul of the earth. If you do not tell yourself, nobody's going to tell you. tell yourself that I am the soul of the earth. Hallelujah. So 13 says, you are the salt of the earth. But if the salt loses its flavor, this is New King James Version. But if the salt loses its flavor, how shall it be seasoned? It is then good for nothing, but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot by men. You are the light of the world. Say, I am the light of the world. It doesn't matter if the world has rejected me. I am the light of the world. It doesn't matter if the world has rejected me. I carry God in me. Amen. 14 says, you are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. Amen. Amen. 15 says, nor do they light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all those who are in the house. 16 says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. I'm here to tell somebody that as you are coming in this house, each and every day, may people start seeing the light of God shining upon your life. Amen. Hallelujah. I say, as you are coming in this house, each and every day, may the light of the Lord shine upon your life so that people may learn from the light that is shining out from your life. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. So, going further, my notes say that we all impact others whether we are aware of it or not. I gave an example of Minister Masri, right, that Minister Lebo will bring in visitors. If they see Minister Masri, she's cleaning, you know, she's going like, you know, up and down. Sometimes you don't know whose attention did you get. Like, you don't know how many people are looking at you as you are going up and down, up and down. So we all impact others. Let me tell you something. You can inspire somebody to do what you are doing, because they see that she is very beautiful. She's so learned. She has a degree. She's very rich. But she put everything aside just to come in this house, just to worship God, just to minister. Amen. So we all impact others, whether we are aware of it or not. And each believer is a unique person created by God for his purposes. People of God, it is high time we stop laughing at people when you hear that they have a certain way of preaching. As I've said here, each believer is a unique person created by God for his purposes. Never question their preaching. Your business, if you see a mistake, your business, kneel down and say, God, I don't understand. What is going on? You don't want to laugh. You don't want to spread rumors. You do not want to gossip. If you can't change the situation, kneel down and say, God, you led me to this house. You led me to this house. I want to receive you through the woman of God that you have called. But the thing is that when she preaches, she stutters. I can't hear her. When she preaches, her English is too English. It's too Englishy. Her English is broken. I can't hear her. I want to hear you, God, through her, through that broken English. It is not your business to judge people, because all believers are created in a unique way. Amen. Hallelujah. Each believer is a unique person created by God for his purposes, and it's his will that we live to impact other people for their spiritual growth. How then are you going to grow spiritually? when I come in front of you with my broken English, with my bad voice, all you could do is to love. How then are you going to grow when you always see the negative in people? How then are you going to learn from God? Because God doesn't call the qualified. This is something that I learned in my growing as a believer. God doesn't call the qualified. That person that didn't go to school is the one that he calls. The same way that the Pharisees were asking Jesus which school that he attend to. Amen. So it's not about them being qualified, but it's all about God. It's all about God. Amen. And the power of our impact is determined by the integrity of our lives. To help us understand that Jesus used two common terms, which is salt and light. Amen. The power of our impact is determined by the integrity of our lives. To help us understand that Jesus used two common terms, salt and light, to emphasize the importance of character and lifestyle for the effectiveness of our witness for him. Amen. This is why we read Matthew 5, verse 13 to 16. Amen. So here it's saying that in my notes, salt is different from the substance it touches. Amen. Salt is different from the substance it touches. And we are also different and separate from the world. Amen. The same world that we are called to serve, we are different from it. Amen. We are living in the world, but we are not of the world. Amen. Minister Masi, I'm sorry. 2 Corinthians 6, verse 17. So this Bible verse, what it's teaching us is that we are different and separate from the world we impact. Amen. In a society characterized by sin, our holy and purified lives stand in stark contrast. We are different and separate from the world we impact. In a society characterized by sin, our holy and purified lives stand in stark contrast. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I hope I haven't lost you. I hope I haven't lost you. So at first, I had said that we are the chosen generation. As the chosen types of generation doesn't mean that if you are chosen, you know, you're going to live a beautiful life. You know, you're going to live a life that is full of sweets and honey, life that has got beautiful things. No. You are called for the work of God. Hallelujah. You are called to stand in between of those who doesn't know Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. The same way God has stand in, hallelujah, for our sins and died for our sins, it is the same way that you are supposed to be standing in for those who doesn't know Christ. Amen. So we are the chosen generation. We have to be an exemplary youth. Check your circle. Check your friends. They say that, show me us.
Show me your friend and I'll show you.
Exactly. Check your friends, like right now. What are they learning from you? Are they learning gossiping? Are they learning how to fight? Are they learning how to be negative always? What are they learning from you? Are they fruitful since the very day they started knowing you? Did their life change? Did anything about them change? So I want you, as we are going to Leather's house, go back to your house in your secret place. Check, my brother, check my sister, that okay, I have this friend that I've been keeping for quite a long time, and this friend of mine worships me like no other. They say that they see God in me, but I do 1, 2, 3. What exactly am I doing? Check yourself, my brother. Don't continue saying, I'm a role model, you know, I got so many followers, you know, those Instagram influencers, whatever, TikTok. The people who are following you, what are they learning? Are they learning to grow spiritually? Or what exactly? Are you teaching them how to smoke? Are you teaching them how to drink? Or you are teaching them to kneel down whenever they are going through problems? And are you rebuking them in love when they do something bad, or you condemn them? Which is which? Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be unto Jesus. God is good. Amen. So going on in my mouth. Us, the chosen generation, the salt of the earth, we relate to the world as salt does with the substance it touches. Salt flavors. It has power to turn what is tasteless into something enjoyable. Have you tried a pub with a meat that doesn't have salt? You haven't? My sister, you haven't? Yes. Yes. So, salt flavors, it has the power to turn what is tasteless into something enjoyable. Salt penetrates. The Holy Spirit uses our godly example, amen, and witness to drive the truth into the heart in such a way that it permeates the entire person. Whenever you stand in front of people here, have you ever checked yourself that, okay, how many people are learning from what I'm saying? How many people are grabbing each and every word that I'm teaching? How many people are being healed? How many people are receiving all those words that I'm teaching? Amen. Hallelujah. Salt creates thirst. Believers are living examples of your transformation. I always tell you that when I came here, I wasn't like this woman. I became this woman by prayer and by the person that has been leading me, Dr. Jerome. If they do something to me, I'll come crying. Then this one, sure.
feel like, okay, she's not fair to me. But that was not her. It was God. God was saying, learn from her. Because that was not about her. It was about my spiritual growth. And there are a lot of things that she doesn't know that I learned from her. And there are also a lot of things that Dr. John doesn't know that I learned from them. That's the same thing that I'm saying, that whenever you spend in front of people, how many people are learning from you? Are you really the soul of the earth? How many people are being influenced by you in a good way, not in a bad way? So salt creates thirst. Believers are living examples of spiritual transformation. The joy, peace, and contentment that Christ gives us are attractive to thirsty souls whom the Spirit is drawing to the Savior. So this is how I came here. Then I didn't even like to be in this house. Dr. Jerome's English was making noise in my ears. But it drew me closer and closer. From the day that he gave me the mic, my daughter, you have to lead prayer. I started reading prayers. I'll be reading when I pray. Father God, she gave me a nickname. I forgot about it. Father God, Father God, Father God. But that alone, you know, I got used to it. I got used to it that, okay, after 7, morning glory to pray. My mind was not programmed to eat. Okay, number 7. We have to be starting. At first I was late, but you know, as time goes by, I started coming in early because I loved music. When I sing, you know, I get my confidence, you know, and then I go on the pulpit, I did my prayers, I'm done. She used to laugh at me, but it's not. It helped. Because now, even if we are not having a morning glory prayer, something in me will tell me that there is something that is missing, Luna. There is something that you did not do. Who would walk from Pretoria coming here lightning in the rain? Like it will be raining. Who will know that we have to pray? So, salt creates thirst. Believers are living examples of spiritual transformation. The joy, peace, and contentment that Christ gives us are attractive to thirsty souls whom the Spirit is drawing to the Savior. Amen. And salt is quiet. Sometimes God draws people to Christ through the quiet means of observation. As they see our godly behavior, gracious responses, and patience, endurance, their hearts may be opened to the gospel. Minister Maslin this other day said that she went to stock, and then someone hit her. So she said the older would have retaliated. But the thing is that because of God, because of the Spirit of God that is inside of her, walk away. She might not know that person just by her being calm with the response that she gave. She might have won a soul. And that person learned from her. And you never know how many people he has also taught through Minister Maslin. So during the midst of fights, yes, during the against, how many things, how many situations are you solving? I'm always fighting with my brother because of talking. How many things are you solving just by being quiet? They say that silence is golden. Some things are not for you to respond. Some things are for the Holy Spirit to deal with. Someone can be convicted by your silence. You just say in your heart, God, she or he is attacking me. You know, God, we have anger issues. But can you please do something? Keep quiet. You will see them. They will walk away. They will walk when they crucified Christ, they didn't fight back, did he? He didn't. So why would you? If they slap you on your left cheek, give them the right cheek. When they go back, you have to be like, yes, I can talk more than him, I can beat more than him. But amongst those people, maybe there will be five, there will be one person who has learned from that person, the other person that you have beaten. So what are you doing? Are you seasoning the earth, or you're just telling yourself that I'm the salt of the earth? I season the earth. I season the earth. And salt heals. As salt gives relief to a sore throat, so we are called to offer healing to a broken world. Compassion, kindness, and a listening ear. Let hurting people experience Christ's love through us. My brother, my sister, if you didn't know that there is power in your mouth, whatever word that you say, it might bring healing to somebody, which is why it is very important when a person comes to you, before you judge them, sit down, listen to them. Listen to them. And before you also give them your big, big English, they don't want to hear your big, big English in order for them to be healed. Humble yourself, my friend. Say, God, who am I? Mama Tembi came to me, she trusted me, you know, with her confidential stuff. And you know, my heart is very small, I can't keep information. But I believe that it is the Holy Spirit that has led her to me. So God, I don't have the right words to tell her. I have pride, but please God, take me off from my high horses so that she can be healed, so that he may be healed. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Come on, somebody. I just want you to be on your feet right now. I want you to be on your feet this moment. Come on, somebody. Let us be on our feet. Amen. I want you to say to yourself, I am the souls of the earth.
I am the
souls
of the earth.
I season the world. I am the light of the earth.
I am the light of the world.
I influence the world.
I influence the world.
I am a great impact to the world.
I am a great impact to the
world. You, spirit of pride, standing on my way. Not to do the work of God. Not to fulfill the work of God. I say, leave my body right now. Somebody, I say, I want you to leave my body right now. Spirit of pride. Spirit of pride. Leave my body right now. Because I am an exemplary youth. Come on, somebody, pray. Open up your mouth and pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we glorify your name this afternoon. God, we pray this morning, oh God, as we want, oh God, to be the soul of the earth, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we pray for your spirit, oh God, to go before us in the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord. Have your way in our lives, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, as we are praying, oh Lord, continuing, oh God, with your work, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, let your spirit, oh God, go before us, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, let the Holy Spirit, oh God, navigate in the mighty name of Jesus, make a way, oh God, where there is no way, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Jesus. Oh God, Lord, we need a change in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, we need a change in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, Lord, we need your people, oh God, to learn from us in the mighty name of Jesus as the chosen generation in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, Heavenly Father, we bless your holy name. Oh God, we want to seize the earth in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, let your spirit, oh God, go before us in the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, somebody take these 2 minutes to pray in the mighty name of Jesus and answer your call this afternoon. Answer your call this afternoon. Jesus, oh God, sweet of the living Father, oh Lord, we pray, oh God, that you may be in this place, in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus, we are the soul of the world. The world. We are not heated, but we are refueled for the purpose of the kingdom of God. We bring value, we bring the light, we bring direction, we bring solutions, we bring life when there is death. We shine the light when people are in darkness. In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, help us to lead in examples. Be an example of Christ in the name of Jesus. Be an example of Christ in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Before I hand over the mic, do we have people amongst us who haven't received Christ as their personal and Lord Savior? I'm kind of asking to step forward so that we may help you, we may lead you to Christ as chosen generation. Amen. I believe we are all served. Amen. So I'm going to leave this time at the hands of Minister Masley. May we all put our hands together. She is walking on front. Amen.
I testify every day. Amen. Amen.
20 consecutive years burn up my drugs. Trupa makulu, vele vengu makabi, ya mpata ya spamu, ya vena le. Tine sen chachela na vanda wa chen sama drugs, sama drugs. Mare tine, before Mulan, yonke vendo vengu yereza emeni, betrini kani sinyeme. Kani nyeme lezi, chanda za ukulu kulu, kuzi amkipe, kulu mnyama lomu, mpila, wapa nchile namba merehebo. Avuvuka avuvuka sahamba siyi-31 mhlawumbe kuliya 31 kusele ama-homeboys wam ayi-5 and then they are all dead. Ya imisebenzi ebesiyenza mhlawumbe bekufanele kwesinye isikhathi ngiyamantu ngiyathula ngibheke emuva le nokuzibuza ukuthi what if yimi engife ngalilalama ngaleya ndlela leya umfethu afe ngayo right mavuvuka kwabangani ojubalandeaujida masilimu bengingaka kana mvuvukile ngidlula wena. Itheks avuvukile kanjalo ngahamba ngayisibhedlela. Iy'mpahla zambe zingasamlimali, ngifuna ukukhatha le story short. Iy'mpahla zingasamlimali, ngahamba ngayesibhedlela, ngabuya, kwadlula iviki or 2, kungenzakali niks. Ngelinye ilanga amajoyini wami besiwahluka, ahluka, ahluka wonke, ngayehla ebhedeni ngalala phansi. Sesekhona ngalungelo, ngalala phansi. Futhi ngiyabhenelwa ngizwa kahle nakuthi angiyafa manje. Inyembezi ziphuma ngapha nangapha andiweke kubhenelwa ngakhona. Kungene 2 of my homeboys abangani bami, yibo-ke labanye badlala bangapha ncele kwami basiyogama. Bangene lo munye ame ngaphethe lo munye ame ngaphethe wena. Babuza ndoda kwenza njani, ngithe ngafa madoda. Lo munye lo bekuyibhelele kushuthi manje mhlambe bekungathi mhlawumbe iy'nkilo zikasathane yabona bewele kasilehe nakhona. Mara ngelalanga wathi ndoda angeke ufe namhlanje yabona, hathi sicele uNkulunkulu asikhombise ukuthi ukhona la. Angokutshela kwisigebengu nawe wenge ummele la estradeni. Wambamba nenyawo lomthinta lo wazi ngoba alobathandaza thandaza thandaza ngaze ngakhala ngakhala ukhala lokwamampela wathandaza uthandaza wakuyelela waphuma wahamba. Aba ukutshela isitori angeke kumane ngisukume lapha phansi ngizomala phambi kwakho ngokutshela into engekho ngithi mina ngakusasa kuseni ngavuka kuyini ngibona wonke amathambo wami la emzimbeni. Ngendaba zokuthandaza namanje ngiyazama ngiyazama otherwise uNkulunkulu ukugcina kuze kufike isuku lanamhlanje. Ngicela uNkulunkulu ukuthi angigezelele amalanga. That is why ngithi ngingatestify every day ngoNkulunkulu. Amen. Siyabonga.
Doesn't pass a month or two.
start talking about offering, about tithing and what, we all don't want to hear about that. We say that pastors or ministers, they love money. But when you come to think of it, the building, somebody is paying rent for it. It's not for free. The company, somebody paid for it. The lights, somebody paid for it. So even the Bible says money answers all things, right? Let me have money. See me, my hairstyle will change. So please say this after me. I'm so happy and grateful now. That money comes to me. In increasing quality. Through multiple sources. On a continuous basis. As we give today's offering. We are believing the Lord for. Jobs and better jobs. Raises and bonuses. Sales and commissions. Settlements. Estate and inheritance. Interest and income. Rebates and returns. Checks in the mail. Gifts and prizes. Finding money, holding on paychecks, bills paid up, tax demands, say royalties received. Come on, say royalties received. Tax demands. Favor of God.
Hallelujah. Glory be unto Jesus.
So there are a few people that I saw walking in when I was already done. I'm here to tell you that as you come here for the morning glory prayer, as you come for our Sunday services, do not leave the word in this house. Go out there, preach the word of God. We are not asking you to come here and preach. Go out there, meet new people. Even greeting somebody that you met in the room and say, "Hi sister, how are you doing? God loves you." You don't know. It really helps. It really, really helps. So let's go out there. Spread the word. Spread the love of God. So I'm going to leave you with this. While Jesus was in the world, he was the light of the world. That's John 9, verse 5. But now he is at the Father's right hand in heaven, and he has left his church. Who is church? It's you and I. He has left his church here to be the light to the world. If you see that people around you are not changing, something is wrong with you. And if you also see that there is somebody that you're trying to follow, you've met someone, your role model, but nothing is changing in your life, my brother, let the Holy Spirit guide you. Tell God that I'm not learning anything. It's time for me to move on. Amen. So if people are looking up to you and you see that there is nothing that is changing in them, check yourself. Amen. While Jesus was in the world, he was the light of the world. But now he is at the Father's right hand in heaven. And he has left his church here to be the light to the world. As the church proclaims the word of God, it's a bright beacon showing people the way to salvation. As we are going to come tomorrow for our morning glory prayer, let's love one another. Let's come prepared to preach. Let's come prepared to minister. Amen. Let's also come prepared to learn. Not from only the person who will be standing on the pulpit, even from the brother who will be seated next to you. Amen. May God bless you. So tomorrow, moving on, it's a new week. We're going to have our morning glory prayer. And in the afternoon, Minister Lebo, she's going to teach us spiritual exhortation. And on Tuesday, we are going to have communication skills class 102. I've already started last week. And on Wednesday, leadership development class 102. And on Thursday, we are on sales and presentation class 101. And on Friday, we are going to have